guys, this is Dipti and welcome to my channel Life Admin 365 and welcome to today's video. Today's video is a recipe video and I'm sharing with you how to prepare restaurant style fluffy basmati rice, the rice which is not sticky and you can see each and every grain in the rice. To start, I'm going to take 2 cups of basmati rice and transfer it to a bigger bowl. Then I'm going to rinse this rice maybe 2 or 3 times with cold water or until the rinse water runs clear. The purpose of rinsing is to make sure that any surface starch on rice is removed. Once that is done, I'm going to add 4 cups of cold water to the 2 cups of the basmati rice that I have taken. And I'm going to let it sit for good 20 to 30 minutes. So at least 20 minutes and no more than 30 minutes. That is the first step in preparing basmati rice. So let's get started. Just make sure that you are rinsing the rice grains very gently because you don't want to break the rice grain. Otherwise, you won't get the long fluffy basmati rice that you are looking for. So, very gently wash the rice grain. You can see that the water is not clear. So, we have to continue rinsing until the water becomes clear. See, this is the second time I'm rinsing it. The water is a little bit clearer than it was the first time. This indicates that the surface starch is, getting removed. And once again, we have to be very gentle when we are rinsing the rice. Otherwise, we are going to break the rice grain. So with each rinse, the water is becoming clearer and clearer. I have done 3 rinses and I think that this is good enough, that this water is clear enough for me to begin my soaking process. So I'm adding 4 cups of water and I'm going to let it sit for 20 to 30 minutes. It's been about 20 minutes. And now it's time to separate the soaked rice from this excess water. So let's get that step done. Take a large wide pan and boil water. For 2 cups of rice, I'm using 10 cups of water. To this, I'm adding 1 teaspoon of salt and mixing thoroughly. Once water is boiling, it's ready for cooking rice. The next step is to add this soaked and drained rice to the water that is boiling in the pot. After adding the rice, I'm giving it a good stir. I'm going to cook the rice for 5 and 6 minutes. That's it. You don't need to overcook this rice. Once the water is boiling, it takes only about 5 to 6 minutes to get the basmati rice cooked. We are aiming to cook the rice maybe only up to 85%. We are not going to completely cook the rice. Otherwise, the rice grain is going to break and it's going to become sticky, starchy, or clumped up together. Anyways, towards the end of 4 minutes, you can see that there is a starchy, foamy liquid that is gathering in the center of the pan. Remove this foamy, starchy water. Doing this prevents the rice grains from sticking to each other. Towards the end of 5th minute, turn off the heat and let the residual heat cook the rice for another minute or so. The next step is to transfer this cooked rice to a colander and get rid of all the hot water. It is very important to stop the rice from cooking further. So I'm going to immediately wash it with some water. I'm using a cold water spray, but room temperature water also works. Rinsing or washing the rice with cold water serves two purposes. One is that it stops the cooking process, and second is that it removes any additional starch that is sticking to the rice grains. Gently shake the colander and move the rice around inside so as to remove any of those last water droplets that are hanging around to your cooked rice. Use it immediately to prepare biryani, pulao or jeera rice, or let it dry for 2 to 3 hours before transferring it to a container and refrigerating it. Refrigerated basmati rice makes excellent fried rice. That is the reason why I made a double batch of basmati rice. Half I am using for making biryani and the other half I'm going to use it at a later time to prepare veg fried rice. Here is a quick recap of how I prepare fluffy, non-sticky, restaurant style basmati rice. I hope this video provided you some value and you did enjoy watching this video. If you did, don't forget to give this video a big thumbs up and do consider subscribing to my channel. Your likes and subscription encourage me to put out new videos on my channel. And don't forget to press the bell icon for further notifications.